Is the Ender 5 Plus the best large bed printer you can get? Well, in today's video, I'm gonna cover assembly, tips and tricks, leveling the bed, first prints, and my first thoughts. In today's video, come check it out. Hi, what's up everyone? Back at it again. It is DW Darkwing Dad, and today I am going to be giving you a glimpse of a new printer. It's new to me. It's not really new to 3D printing. It's the Ender 5 Plus. So it was the printer that I originally had my eyes on when I wanted to get my first printer. However, I just didn't have room for it. And in all reality, I still don't have room for it, but I made it work. So in today's video, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna cover how to assemble the printer, how to level your bed, and then just some tips and tricks, some of my first prints, just my overall review and thoughts on the printer. What I'm gonna do now is just kinda show you the assembly. Let me show you the assembly. We'll get right into leveling the bed, and then I'll show you some of my first prints and give you my final thoughts.
All right, so first when you're setting up your Ender 5 Plus, you want to make sure you have a nice big work area. This is a little bit different than a conventional 3D printer. It's basically a big cube with additional rails and just a lot more to it to putting it together. So make sure you unpack it safely, get all the bolts and everything that you need out, and just have a nice work area to work in. Once everything's unpacked, you can start with the base in the control box, and then you're gonna start screwing the vertical supports in place. They are held in place by two M5 bolts on the bottom of each support. You wanna make sure there is a threaded opening, and that you wanna have go towards the top, because that's gonna be an additional support for your top gantry. So take the two M5 bolts and use the supplied Allen key, tighten those on nice and firm, and then you can start putting your top gantry on. Once those vertical supports are nice and snug, you can put your top gantry on here. This is basically your X and Y carriage, your hot end, your extruder, all that stuff is gonna be attached to this. So you wanna go around and use those same M5 bolts and fasten the bolts onto the top and to the side. Make sure they're snug, tight, but not too tight. So after that's nice and secure, you wanna grab another bag of M5 bolts and you wanna start putting your Z-rails on. This also has the stepper motors in and everything. You can see right there, and you want those facing the back. In the instruction manual, it actually shows facing one forward and one back, but trust me, you want both of them facing to the rear. So basically they just kinda line up with that bottom rail support, and you're gonna take some M5 bolts and just screw those in place nice and firmly. Make sure everything's level. There's my dog Spunky coming in to say hi. Making sure everything's nice and tight and snug and good to go. Next, you actually want to take the Z-rail and actually loosen it to drop the build plate down. It's all the way to the top and you won't be able to actually put the glass bed on. So you just want to drop it a little bit, make sure all your harnesses are out of the way, and put that build plate on, and you're going to secure it in place with some M4 bolts. Just take the glass bed off because it's a lot easier to get that screwed in place with it off than with it on. Once that's done, I recommend grabbing a small level and raising your bed back to the top. This just makes sure that both rails are completely level and you won't have any issues when you get into printing. Next, we can start plugging wires in. So everything's pretty much proprietary or color-coded. So our hot end wire there, big yellow plug, we're gonna plug that in. Next, E, that's for the extruder. We're gonna plug that in. That's the back of the machine just above the filament runout sensor. Make sure that's snug and good to go. Next, we're gonna plug in our Z stepper motors. There's one on each side of the control box, left and right. You basically just wanna plug those in. Just make sure they're firm. Run the cable over, around, behind the control box and plug it into the other stepper motor. You can see it's nice and clean to an extent. Looks pretty good, plugged in, good to go. Next, we're moving on to the Y cables here, and that's basically the stepper motor that moves the bed forward and back. It's also the Y pin sensor there, you can see. So the smaller plug plugs into that little sensor, and the bigger one is going to actually plug into the stepper motor. Just make sure it's nice and firm and you're good to go. once the Ys are all good, we're gonna plug the X cables in, and that is what moves the hot end basically left to right. So the stepper motor is right there, and then just like the Y had that little pin sensor, the X is gonna have one too. It's basically, it's called a limit switch, and that's what stops it. It clicks it and detects it and tells it to stop. So that's plugged in, all good to go. Now we're gonna move into all the additional cables for the hot end, for the filament runout sensor, for the heated bed, things like that. So these are all pretty much proprietary. They just plug right in. There's only one way you can plug them in. They're all labeled and everything, and they're all color coded. So just plug those in, make sure they're nice and firm, and you're good to go. Lastly is gonna be your filament runout sensor. That's the yellow and red wire. That's what detects your filament. So if you run out of filament while you're printing, it will pause the machine. Then using the supplied bolts, just mount the filament holder on the back of the carriage. Make sure that it is pointing outwards, because if you have it inward, it may hit the bed as it lowers during printing. Then you want to take the bone tube coming from the hot end and place it into the extruder. So decompress the gray plug by pushing on it gently and push the tube in firmly. When it goes in all the way, take the little blue supplied clip and that will fasten it in place. After the blue clip is in place, just give it a little bit of a tug just to make sure it's nice and firm and you're good to go. Lastly, all you want to do is just a little bit of wire management. Most important things, we want to make sure we're not restricting the cables or it's not hitting the gantry or anything that might be moving. So just use the supply zip ties, just kind of put them where you will, make it look nice and clean, and you're good to go. Now on most of the Ender 5 Pluses that are older, there will be a switch right on the side. It's a red little switch. It says 110 or 220. You'll have to flip that to 110, but on the newer Ender 5 Pluses, they're voltage selecting, so there's no need to flip the switch. You just plug it in, it detects the voltage, and you're good to go. Once that's all set up, you can plug it in, turn it on, and get your machine ready to go. What I'll do now is show you a little bit of bed leveling and some of the features of this printer and give you my opinions and show you some of the first prints I knocked out. So for bed leveling, just preheat your bed and your hot end to your operating temperature. So selecting PLA is fine for this. We want to level it at what we're going to be printing at, because as things heat up, they can expand or contract. Next, go to settings, and what you're going to do is you're going to go to leveling, and it is going to auto home the hot end in the proper place, and it will basically get ready for the leveling process. Now, what you want to do from here is you want to go ahead and select aux leveling, and what it's going to do is you're going to level it at 5 points in the bed. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is where you're still going to do paper leveling. Even though this has a BL touch, you still have to level the bed first before the BL touch can probe the bed and check for minor dips and imperfections and things like that. So you want to start off at point one, and what you're going to do is just put a piece of paper under the hot end, and you're going to tap the number one, and it is going to raise the bed, because of course this works differently, so it's going to raise the bed up to that hot end. And what you want to do is wiggle the paper back and forth, and you don't want it too loose, but you don't want it too tight. If the paper doesn't move at all, it's way too tight and you have to adjust the bed. You have to release or decompress those springs, okay? You can kind of see in the corner there my hands turn, and I'll get a better visual of what it is now. But basically on the Ender 5 Plus, if you turn the knobs of the bed to the left, it's going to loosen the bed, so it's actually going to drop it, and if you turn it to the right, it's going to raise it. So lefty loosey, righty tighty. So you just want to kind of jiggle that paper underneath. You can see me turning the nozzle or the knob here on the bed, and what you want, you just want a little bit of friction between the paper and the hot end. You don't want it to just glide freely, but you don't want it to not move at all. So basically what you do is you go through the entire sequence there, 1 through 5, and at each point where the hot end moves to, you want to slide the piece of paper under there. Just make sure you have a little bit of grip, but not too much. And once all that's done, then we can have the BL touch probe the bed. And this is the sequence where we're going to initiate the BL touch. What this is going to do is this is going to probe 16 points on the bed just to ensure it is leveled properly. It's, like I said, basically probing the bed, scanning for any sort of dips or imperfections that might not be there with the leveling. It'll give you exact measurements, but like I said, this is just a fall safe just to reinforce and make sure that your bed is properly leveled. Once the BL touch has completed its sequence, it's going to give you measurements of the entire bed. Generally, you want these numbers pretty close. If they're not to your liking, you can always go back and re-level your bed with the paper and have it re-probe. But generally, when the BL touch does this sequence and completes it, it means that the bed is good to go and you should be ready to print. After that, it's just selecting a file, loading your filament, and hitting print, and you're good to go. So far, I really like the Under 5 Plus. It's a very unique design, a very sturdy and durable machine, even with Hulk trying to beat it up. It's given me some really good quality prints early on, and I really like it. With this, I do utilize the hairspray bed adhesion technique, where I basically flip it upside down, use the glass bed, and use hairspray. I've done this with my CR10 V3, the V2, and also with my newer CR6 SE. Basically, flip it upside down, spray some hairspray on there, whether you're using brim, skirt, whatever, it works great. Absolutely love it. And what I want to do now is actually show you some of my first prints that I've done with the Under 5 Plus, so come check these out.
Well, that's pretty much it, guys. That is a look at the Ender 5 Plus. If it is a printer you are considering, it's a good consideration because it is a pretty awesome printer. Generally, the whole structure of the printer, it's very sound, durable. I feel like you can print at a little bit higher of a speed because, it's almost like a big cage. Constructed very well. I feel that there's a lot less stress on the X and the Y carriage because that build plate just drops. And I think that's the whole idea behind the design. Looking at other printers, how there's just so much stress on the X and the Z, where it's moving left to right and moving up, and then you have, you know, a moving part on the bottom of the Y bed, whereas with the 5 Plus, the bed just slowly drops, and all it's really doing is there's just less movement, so I feel like it can print a lot smoother, can print a lot faster, you get a lot better quality prints, and you've seen from some of those shots there, you know, how good of prints I'm getting, you know, out of just, you know, 0.2 layer height. It's a pretty awesome machine, you know. BL Touch, the way it came configured, I know I did a video in the past where I wasn't really a fan of it. It seems to be fine on this, but I'll repeat myself, where just proper bed leveling goes a long way. You don't need a BL Touch. Realistically, if this didn't have a BL Touch, it probably wouldn't matter. It would still print the same, but it came with it, so I'm rolling with it. So far, it has been great. Really, the only cons to this machine are, one, the size, and two, the sound. It does not have a silent board, which I will definitely be getting, because this thing trumps my CR10, which was by far the loudest printer I've ever had. This thing is loud, so if you're gonna have it in a room where you're sleeping or a room where you need to be on the phone a lot, I don't recommend it. When that thing prints at night and during the day, the door is closed because it is loud. It literally cascades through the whole house. So that's really the only downside. The plus side is, from the research I've done, the Ender 5 Plus board, it's just a quick swap. It's something where you take it apart, put it in, plug in the SD card there, and it's self-configured. So I will be doing a video on that. I've already ordered the board, so that will be in a future video. I'll also be showing you how to fine-tune your Ender 5 Plus. I've already done it with mine. I'm actually going to be showing you how to fine-tune your Ender 5 Plus. We'll cover temp towers, retraction tests, flow, And obviously E-steps and everything, so that will be a video that should be out hopefully within the next week. It can be applied to other printers, but I'm going to kind of highlight the Ender 5 Plus because it really is a pretty popular machine. And truthfully speaking, I think as far as a first printer or a large bed printer, it really is, it just gives you size that some of the other printers like the CR10 V2, CR10 V3, some of those 300 by 300s just don't offer. As long as you have the space for the printer, I think it's very structurally sound. I think it has a ton of possibilities. Could it use some upgrades like the silent board? Yes. Does it need them? Absolutely not. Out of the box, once it's calibrated, it is really, so far, it's honestly been the best printing printer I've done. My V2, my V3, I've had to do constant tweaks along the way. This thing, knock on wood, so far, it has been great. The only issue I did have with it was my front gantry bracket. It was bent a little bit and it caused the belt to rub. It was from the Y. It's adjusted that. I've seen the belt fraying a little bit. I just had to adjust that, bend the bracket over a little bit. Other than that, it's been fantastic, out of the box. So I definitely recommend it if you are looking for a large bed printer. Two thumbs up on this one. That's it for this video, guys. Like I said, I wanted to showcase this printer for you. It had been sitting in a box for about 38 or 39 days when I got it. I didn't have anywhere to put it. I had family in town staying in the spare room there. And it was just kind of chilling in a closet, and I finally got it set up. And so far, it's been absolutely fantastic. And I can't wait to print more things with it, learn more tips and tricks and share them with you, and hopefully they help you if you have an Ender 5 or any other machine similar to it. To all my subscribers, thank you so much. I do appreciate the feedback, the love, if that's a heart, and just everything you guys contribute to the channel. I hope you guys are enjoying the videos. Obviously, there's going to be lots more to do. Currently, I'm working on a couple videos I should have out within the next week, a wet sanding best practices, and I will be announcing my next subscriber giveaway. And I've got a couple other projects. If you guys see some of the posts that I do on the YouTube there, you'll see some of the projects that I'm doing. So make sure to check back for those. And obviously, if you're on the Discord, drop me a line if you have any questions or you're wondering what's up next or anything like that. You know I'll respond back. If you're not a subscriber to the channel and you enjoy all things 3D printing, Marvel, Star Wars, Disney, DIY projects, and just me flipping my fingers in front of a camera, go ahead and click that subscribe button, because like I said, I'll have a lot more videos and a lot more content on the way for you guys in the future to hopefully help you with all your 3D print and cosplay needs. That's it for now, guys. I am done. I got to get back to Boba Fett. That is my current project that I'm working on. I got to get that wrapped up. So you guys should see some content, some part one on that, hopefully within the next week. Show you some new sanding and smoothing tips. But I'm going to get back to that. You guys let me know what you think. Give me a thumbs up if you like this video. Drop me a comment if you have an Ender 5 Plus. Share your experience with me, and we can share it with others. And until next time, DW out. Later.